Welcome to Pranab Sir's classes. Today I am going to discuss with you language and its four basic skills. The prime purpose of my classes is to develop in you the skills of English language. Before we go to the skills of language, we must know what is language. So language is just a means of communication. Through language we express our thoughts, our feelings, and when we talk about how can we learn a language, actually language is not taught, language is learned, and language is a skill. As you know, when we are going to learn riding a cycle and we'll tell a person that this is the pedal, this is the handle, this is the pedal, this is the seat, where you have to sit. Simple knowledge to a particular boy or girl is not sufficient. We have to hand over the cycle to the boy or girl so that he or she can learn riding a cycle. Similarly, when you talk about learning computer, it is also a skill, like riding a cycle. Suppose you have not touched the computer, you are not having the practice of doing something in computer for a long period of time, you may remember the board, but you may forget some of the keys of the board. So language is learned, not but taught, and language is a skill. So why should we learn all these skills of language? Now we have to understand and we have to produce the language, because the purpose of each of us is to understand a language and produce language. That's why we have to learn the skills of language. Another very important thing that I might have told you in my earlier classes, that in the present world, the communication plays a very important role. So to have an effective communication, to develop our communication skill, we must learn the language skills. So when we talk about language skill, the skills of language are of four types. They are listening, speaking, reading, and writing. And these language skills are divided into two classes. One is the receptive and the other is productive. Receptive, listening, and reading, these two are classified as the receptive skills. We receive knowledge through listening and reading. And productive includes speaking and writing. Through speaking and writing, we produce language. And whenever you talk about the learning of language in a natural way, which is very important, and while we teach or while we talk about the learning of language skills, at that time everyone of us must know about the natural way of learning a language. Let's talk about a baby. So when a baby is 1 year old, the baby starts speaking language. First one letter, then words, then sentences, small sentences, then long sentences. So how a baby speaks something? Now, when the baby listens something, then only the baby speaks. So it is a very natural process that whatever we listen, that we speak. If we don't listen anything, we cannot speak. Sometimes our tongue may be talkative. Our tongue is perfect. There is no problem in our tongue. But if there is problem in the ear, then we cannot talk, because this is the input and this is the output. And we can take an example. Very close to my native, there is a tribal village, Jinjiri Ponga. So if a baby takes birth today in that village and will sit the same tribal baby to Washington DC with proper nursing, and again if will bring back the baby, the boy or girl here after 10 years, then the baby will be speaking not tribal language, not the language of the parents, but the language of Americans or the language of Washington DC. Why is this possible? Now, because the child listened American English and the child produced American English. Let's go to the next part, that is the reading and writing. Many of my students argue with me that writing is first and reading is next. Can you draw the picture of my girl, picture of my daughter, Prakriti? If you have seen my daughter, then only you can draw the picture of my child. Because if you have not seen to a particular picture, you cannot write. So that seeing is reading and that drawing is writing. Unless and until we see something, we cannot write or we cannot draw. So reading comes first and writing comes last. Naturally, a baby learns the language in this way, that first is listening, then is speaking, next is reading, and the last is writing. And while some parents, they focus on the writing skill initially, I must advise them that while learning a language, specifically I will focus on the second language, English language. While learning this second language or English, try to focus on this natural path. Finally, I must tell one thing to you all, that listening develops the speaking skill and reading develops the writing skill. And if we don't have these four skills of language, then we can never tell that we have known a language. If you say you know English language, you must have the skill of listening and understanding, speaking a language for the understanding of others, reading English and understanding, and writing English for the understanding of others. That's all for today. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Sanskriti here. Did you like Pranav sir's class? It was really amazing, no? I have never heard it before from anyone. So let us know your like and by giving comment and share. Thank you.